Hi dear student, in previous video for especially for BSc student we have discussed about the integral and differential form of Faraday's law. Then today we will learn our next article, that is the displacement current, that is the displacement current. So we hear the word conduction current, but what is meant by displacement current, what is the source of a displacement current? You know that student, in case of the conduction current, the source of conduction current, it is the motion of the electric charge. So it produces the conduction current. But what is the source for displacement current? And today we will discuss all about the displacement current, how this displacement current form, how modification for in case of the Ampere's law by Maxwell. So we will start our article, that is the displacement current. You know that student, in electrostatics, that is the equation of Gauss law, that is del dot E is equal to rho upon epsilon 0. It is the Gauss law for electrostatics, differential form of Gauss law in electrostatics, where rho is the charge density, E is the electric field. Okay, this is our first equation. Del dot E, that is equal to rho upon epsilon 0. And you know that student, epsilon 0, it is the permittivity of free space or vacuum. Okay, so electric charge is in motion, it equivalent to conduction current, that is the electric current, and the flow of but a charge neither created nor destroyed. So flow of current density is equal to the or divergence of J, where that is the current density is denoted by J. The divergence of J is equal to or opposite to rate of change of charge density, and which is given by divergence J, that is del dot J is equal to minus del rho by del T. Del dot J, that is equal to minus del rho by del T, and this equation is also written as del dot J plus del rho by del T is equal to 0. This is our second equation. Del dot J plus del rho by del T, that is equal to 0. This equation is known as the equation of continuity. This equation is known as equation of continuity. Del dot J plus del rho by del T, that is equal to 0. And in case of this Ampere's law, that is, we know that del cross B is equal to mu 0 J. This is our third equation. Del cross B, that is equal to mu 0 J, where mu 0 is the permeability. J is the current density. This is the differential form of the Ampere's law. Del cross B is equal to mu 0 J. This Ampere's law is valid for steady current. But for time varying electric field, that is for non-steady current, there is an inconsistency in this Ampere's law. And so there is a need to modify this Ampere's law.
is Ampere's law, and this is modified by Maxwell. Ampere's law modified by Maxwell. So in case of this, you know that student, del cross B equal to mu zero J. So in case of this equation, that is del dot E, if we take the divergence both side, what, how this equation is modified? If we take the divergence both sides, del dot del cross B, that is equal to mu zero del dot J, del cross B, del divergence of del cross B, that is equal to mu zero del dot J, divergence J. But you know that student, the divergence of curl, that is the divergence of del cross B, is always zero, and from this we get, that is del dot J, that is equal to zero. Del dot J, that is equal to zero. But according to continuity equation, that is a del dot J is equal to minus del rho by del T. That is del dot J is not equal to zero. Del dot J is not equal to zero. So there is a contradiction between this equation and this equation. This equation says that the del dot J is not equal to zero, and this equation is shows that del dot J equal to zero. So del dot J is equal to zero for steady current. Del dot J is equal to zero for steady current. And in case of this varying, that is it is not equal to zero. So there is a need to modify the Ampere's law. There is a need to modify the Ampere's law. And so del cross B plus del cross B, that is equal to mu zero J plus additional torque. Additional torque. Then we have to find out what is the equation, or what is the equation or value of the additional torque. What is the equation or value of the additional torque? And so we write del cross B, that is equal to mu zero J. We know that student, in the case of this equation, that is del dot E equal to rho upon epsilon zero del dot E. We consider the first equation, that is a del dot E is equal to rho upon epsilon zero. So rho equal to epsilon zero del dot E. Rho equal to epsilon zero del dot E, or del rho by del T, that is equal to epsilon zero del dot del E by del T. Epsilon zero del dot del E by del T. Substitute this equation, substitute del rho by del T in a second equation. In second equation, what we get? What we get? That is del dot J, del dot J plus epsilon zero, del dot J plus epsilon zero del dot del E by del T, del dot del E by del T, del dot J plus epsilon zero del dot del E by del T, that is equal to zero. So this equation is written as del dot J plus epsilon zero del E by del T, J plus epsilon zero del E by del T. From this equation, it shows that the for a time varying electric field, that is a del dot J is not equal to zero, but del dot J plus epsilon zero del E by del T, that is equal to zero. And so the Maxwell modified this Ampere's law, and it is written as del cross B, that is equal to mu zero
that is equal to mu 0 j plus epsilon 0 del E by del t. Mu 0 j plus epsilon 0 del E by del t. And this epsilon 0 del E by del t, and this equation is also written as mu 0 j plus j plus that is the jd, j plus jd, where jd equal to epsilon 0 del E by del t, and it is the displacement current density. It is the displacement current density. Means ये जो equation है अपना एम्पियर्स लॉ का जो equation है, ये equation conduction current के लिए valid है. अगर हम non steady current यानी steady current के लिए valid है, अगर हम non steady current and if we discuss about beyond the magnetostatics, then this Ampere's law is not a generalized law. So this Ampere's law is there is an inconsistency in Ampere's law for beyond the magnetostatic. That is in case of this propagation of the electromagnetic waves. This law is failed to explain this propagation. So this is explained by the help of the modified Ampere's law. And so we have to modify this, that is the Maxwell modified the Ampere's law, that is mu 0 j plus jd, where jd is the displacement current density. But you know that student, that is it is the displacement current density. Our article is a displacement current. So we know that a displacement current was obtained from the displacement current density, that is the displacement current flows through any surface S which is given by ID, that is equal to JD dot ds, surface integral. ID that is equal to surface integral JD dot ds. Substitute the values of JD in the above equation, we get ID that is equal to integration, surface integration, that is epsilon 0 del E by del t, epsilon 0 del E by del t dot ds. ID that is equal to surface integral epsilon 0 del E by del t ds. This equation is also written as, that is epsilon 0 del by del t surface integral E dot ds. Epsilon 0 del by del t surface integral E dot ds. But surface integral E dot ds that is equal to phi, so it is the total electric flux, through surface S. Okay, so this equation is written as ID that is equal to epsilon 0 d phi by dt. ID that is equal to epsilon 0 d phi by dt. That is the displacement current is equal to epsilon 0 d phi by dt. Epsilon 0 d phi by dt. Dear student, the idea of displacement current allows us to retain the continuity in case of the charging of the capacitor. That is, when we consider the when
we consider the parallel plate capacitor. When we consider the parallel plate capacitor, parallel plate capacitor, that is the positive charge plate, that is the negative charge plate, and it is the conduction current. Conduction current. Okay. So, in case of the parallel plate capacitor, the electric field is produced between them. But when the conduction current passing through this charge plate of the capacitor, then the charge plate of the capacitor charging, plate of the capacitor charging, and due to this charging, the electric field between the plates changes. Due to this charging, the electric field between the plates changes, and so this changing electric field, this changing electric field is produces the displacement current. It is produces the displacement current produced between gap between two charge plates. Produce the gap between two charge plates. But so because in case of the conduction current, the conduction current charging the plate, but there is a no transfer of charge across the plates. There is a no transfer of charge across the plate. So how this capacitor is continuously charging and discharging? So the conduction current does not involve in case of this. It is not involved. It is not produced between these two charge plate. So it is not a conduction current, but another type of current produced between the two plates of the capacitor, and this is not a conduction current, but this is the another type of this current, and this current is the displacement current. It is produced only when the electric field changes or electric field varies with respect to time. Electric field varies with respect to time. Is it if it is the conduction current, then it is a flows across the plate of the capacitor, but we know that the there is a no transfer of charge, there is a no transfer of charge across the plate of the capacitor. So we say that that is the displacement current. Conduction current is the transfer of charge between one plate to other plate, but displacement current does not involve any conduction current, does not involve into the conduction current. Displacement current does not involve into the nothing to in the conduction current, nothing to into the conduction current. Then then we will study the relation between displacement current and conduction current. How the displacement current is closely related to conduction current? We know that a student, in case of this, when the plate of the capacitor, that is, it is ID, it is the ID. When the plate of the capacitor close to each other, then the electric field between the plates is given by E equal to sigma upon epsilon 0, sigma upon epsilon 0. So sigma is the surface charge density, and in terms of the charge and area, surface charge density is written as sigma equal to q by a, sigma equal to q by a. So e equal to q upon a epsilon 0, E equal to q upon a epsilon 0. So q equal to a epsilon 0 e, q equal to a epsilon 0 e. We know that, student, in case of the conduction current, I equal to dqc. For conduction we write the suffix c, dq by dt, dq by dt. So we write a epsilon 0 dE by dt, a epsilon 0 dE by dt. A epsilon 0 dE by dt. And from this equation, we also written as id. This is our, in this article, this is our third equation. And id epsilon 0 ddt of phi E into A. We know that, student, the electric flux that is equal to EA. So we write that is A epsilon 0, A epsilon 0 dE by dt, A epsilon 0 dE by dt. ID equal to epsilon 0 ddt EA. So A epsilon 0 dE by dt. And from these two equations, it is clear that IC equal to ID. From these two equations, it is clear that IC equal to ID. Means that is the conduction current is closely related to displacement current. Conduction current is closely related to displacement current. And so from this equation, we draw the conclusion that is Maxwell says that during charging and discharging of the capacitor, the conduction, that is the displacement current, that is the displacement current flows across the plates of the capacitor, flows across the plate of the capacitor is closely related to conduction current, is closely related to conduction current in case of the charging and discharging of the capacitor, in case of the charging and discharging of the capacitor. So this is all about the displacement current. Thank you so much, student. BSc के जो स्टूडेंट है, अगर वो हमारे चैनल पे अगर नए हैं तो आप सब्सक्राइब कीजिएगा. अगर आपको, अगर हमारा जो लेक्चरर है वो अगर पसंद आया तो आप सब्सक्राइब कीजिए, आपके फ्रेंड्स को शेयर कीजिए. और जो अभी इसके बाद भी हम 12th के वीडियो निकाल रहे हैं, हम 12th का भी और ये जो है बीएससी के लिए भी हम अभी कंटिन्यूअसली वीडियो निकालने की कोशिश करेंगे और हम अपना काम ये जो है ये जारी रखेंगे. थैंक यू सो मच, स्टूडेंट.